say I'm rich. He puts a thought in your mind. He tell you, that's all right. Do this, do that. Say this, say that. Go there, go here. Do this, do that. Put the thoughts in your mind. Put a thought in your mind, guess what? You start questioning what the word says. So these two followers, one is good, that's Jesus. The other is the devil. So who's your daddy? And ever since he been kicked out of heaven, what he been doing? He been lying. He first came lying to Eve in the garden, right? Yeah. Go ahead, eat. Eyes be open. You be like God. You ain't gonna die. But God said, you'll surely die. So I said, Pedro, discipleship means I'm willing to follow Jesus regardless of the cost. Sometimes it might be difficult, but God's always in control. What if he doesn't bring you through this or that right away? He's still God. What did the Hebrew boy say in the fire first? If you don't believe us, guess what? We know he can. But we still have a lot unto him. Unto Satan. What if time gets hard? He's still God. What if you don't get delivered? He's still God. What if you don't get healed? He's still God. If you don't heal over here, guess what? He healed over there. Because in heaven, there's nothing to fire. There's no sitting in there. If time gets hard, I will still obey. I will still follow Jesus. Psalms 37, 25 says that I've been young, now I'm old. Yet if I've never seen a righteous forsaken, nor seen a seed begging man. Philippians says that my God is able to supply all my needs. And when Abraham offered Isaac on the altar, the Bible says that God will provide himself a ram. Yes, yes. That's a paraphrase, all right, in case your Bible student know that I just told that, all right? Now, we're closing our flex of favorite scripture from Paul writing to the church of Rome. If you want to follow me, go to Romans chapter number 8. Again, at verse 31, I can wait for you. What shall we say to these things? If God be for us, who can be against us? He who did not spare his own son, but lived him up for us all, how shall he not with him so freely give us all things? Who shall bring a charge against God, elect? It is God who justifies. Who is he that condemns? It is Christ who died, and further is also risen, who is even at the right hand of God, who also made an intercession for us. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation, or distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or peril, or sword? As it is written, for your sake we are killed all day long. We are counted as sheep for the slaughter. Yet all these things we are more than our conquerors. I am persuaded that neither death nor life, nor principality, nor powers, nor anything present, nor anything to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any created thing shall be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus. Give God a hand of praise. Nothing shall separate us from the love of God. Nothing shall separate from the love of God. Nothing shall separate me from His love. Hallelujah. stay with Jesus. And he'll stay with you. Worth it for all. So when he said